like a log. It's so peaceful here. God, I need a bit of peace after the year I've had.
I see.
I've had a rough time of it recently, Father. My husband left me for another woman. Though it was my fault, I suppose. The sex was getting a little boring and I did nothing to spice it up.
Isn't that always the way?
But near the end, I tried a few things. I used to dress up in really revealing lingerie, and when he came through the door, I leapt on top of him and had sex right there in the hall.
So you had a good sleep then?
Yes, thank you. Oh, God, I'm sorry, Father. I've probably shocked you.
Go away with you. I've heard far more shocking things down through the years in confession.
Do you ever think about the future, Father?
Oh, I used to think about it, the future, and then it became the present, so I thought about it quite often then, and then it was in the past, so I didn't think about it that much.
Do you like Dostoevsky?
Oh, him, yes, yes. He's one of my favourites. I must have read that book 10 times.
I see you're reading it again. There's a bookmark here on page 7. Did you feel his sense of commitment wane towards the end?
Yes.
When did you feel that began to happen?
Oh, towards the end, you know. After he'd finished writing about the crime bit and moved on to the punishment, you know. Felt it dragged a bit there for me.
I always thought that if Joyce, Keats and Lawrence were sitting in a room together and Dostoevsky walked in, there'd be a hell of a fight for the last piece of pudding. Oh, you know, it's great to talk to somebody about these things. My husband. There was a man who was really afraid of Virginia Woolf.
Why was... Was she following him or something?
Oh, Father. You wouldn't like to come up to the cottage later? For a little drink? Or maybe some more book talk?
That would be delightful.
Sorry?
I'd be delighted at it.
I'll see you later then, Father. About 7.
7 o'clock. 7, right. It's only a drink. So, you'd no trouble getting here?
No. I drove Sister Julia in the Renault. Sister Margaret took the Mini.
It's great having the old car all the same, isn't it? Anyone for more tea?
I don't think so.
Sister Margaret, do you want something?
No, thank you, Father.
Sorry?
She's fine, Father. At what time does the Mass tonight start, Father?
7 o'clock.
Oh, that's grand. We don't want to be too late.
Well, 7 isn't too... Ah!
Father.
Yes, it's... There's just 7 o'clock. I may have to leave early.
During the Mass? Oh, you couldn't leave during the Mass.
It's just that, you see,
Sister Julia says that you say a lovely Mass. She said that you said one of the nicest Masses she ever heard. And Sister Concepta said that last year's Mass here was fabulous. She said she'd give it 10 out of 10, and she's very hard to please. She's seen you do, what, is it about 50 Masses since then? Let's show Father Crilly the photographs, Teresa. You like these, Father? Oh, there's you saying the Mass here last year. And that's you saying the Mass the year before. What's that? Oh, yes, that's your sister-in-law's funeral. That's my personal favourite. That's when you had the beard. Actually, Father, you couldn't sign a few of them for us, could you?
The photographs?
Yes.
All right.
Oh, could you put on my one, Two Sister Assumpta?
Sure.
Oh. Father, Sister Margaret has a question.
Yes?
Where'd you get your ideas for your sermons?
Where'd you get your ideas for your sermons?
Oh, just... overheard conversations, the news, whatever. Listen, I have to be honest here. I
might
not be able to...
Do you have a question? What's your most embarrassing moment saying Mass?
Oh. Well, I suppose it was the time I forgot my sister-in-law's name. That got me a bit hot under the collar. Anyway, the thing is, I might not be able to say this evening's Mass.
What, Father?
I have something quite important to do.
Not more important than saying Mass, Father.
It's just someone I know is dying.
Oh, dear. Is it serious?
Oh, yes. In this case, the person dying is quite seriously ill. It's someone we know very well. Nuns! Nuns! Reverse! 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 Reverse!
No, Father Maguire. Father Crilly was just telling us about your friend dying.
Who was that, Ted?
Old Jim.
Ah, is he dying? Poor old Jim. Won't like that.
He's terribly down about it.
Wait a second. Jim Halpin.
Yes.
Oh, I was just talking to him earlier and he didn't say a thing about it.
Well, that's Jim. Brave is not the word.
He's just outside. Hold on there and I'll get him.
What? What's he doing outside? He should be at home in bed.
Ah, no, you see, I met him earlier. He just wanted to lend us some sugar. Hold on there.
Jim, at a moment like this, this man needs peace. So just don't be... Hello, Jim.
Hello, Father. Hello, sisters.
Now, Jim, you never told me you were ill.
Huh? I had a bit of a cold a few weeks back.
A cold? Well, Ted said you were dying.
Dying? Oh, no. I don't think so, anyway.
Well, it's just I was talking to Dr. Sinnott, and he said... He said that you might be dying, but he wasn't 100% sure himself, so don't go off worrying yourself unnecessarily.
God mighty, I'd better give him a call.
I wouldn't go calling him, Jim.
And why not?
He can't use the phone. He's gone deaf.
Dr. Sinnott's gone deaf. That's terrible.
It is all right.
Second, there he is now. Dr. Sinnott! Doc! He heard that all right, Ted. Doctor, would you have a moment?
Actually, wait! I just remembered! Jim is not dying! And Dr. Sinnott's not gone deaf! I was thinking of two completely different people!
So you will be able to say tonight's Mass then, Father?
Yes, I will, of course. Thanks to Father Dougal for clearing up that little misunderstanding.
Ted, you're hurting me.
All right, listen, Dougal. I'm going to have to go straight after this. You'll have to look after the nuns.
Fair enough, Ted. What'll I do with them?
Whatever you want. Just try not to kill them or anything.
Thanks for that, Ted.
Remember Sister Janita?
Oh, yeah. I was a bit too close for comfort, all right, yeah.
Just be careful this time, Mark. Oh, God. Are they all in there?
Yeah. Like peas in a pub, Ted.
Pod. Right, let's go. See you later.
Okay, good luck, Ted.